Hello everybody, welcome to our steam barrel sterilizer series. In this video we'll show you how to build a mushroom sterilizer.
Hey everyone, this is Phil with Fungi Aquafo. I just wanted to mention that the inspiration from this video was mostly taken from Oak and Spore, and in his video he mentioned you needed your safety crocs. What I have here is I've got the croc brand, but the open-toed version, and no 4x4 in the back. So we'll see how those work and we'll get back to you on that. Thanks everyone.
So my first step was to make basically a holding plate for the sawdust substrates within the barrel. And I created that by cutting out the bottom of an old barrel. Step bit to drill a bigger hole so that I could fit the jigsaw in, and used a metal cutting blade to cut out the plate for the sawdust blocks. Punch out holes roughly an inch and a half apart, and which I measured out in a diagonal pattern. I then used, once again, the step bit to drill holes that were 13/16 in diameter. Once all the holes were drilled, I proceeded to clean the back up, as there is a ton of metal filings hanging off. Next came actually building the barrel itself. So first I punched out two holes for the top of the barrel. I proceeded to drill out those two holes, once again at 13/16, which I found was the best for threading in the pieces afterwards. Next, I punched and drilled the hole for the steam intake. Hole in order to drill for the spigot, which would let off the built up water from the steam in the barrel. Next, I punched and drilled holes for the steam output, as well as on the bottom at an angle off of the steam output for the float valve where the water comes into the stock pot. I then painted the interior of the barrel with a heat and rust resistant trem clad in order to protect the inside. I put on about 3 coats of this. I then insulated the barrel. What I purchased was a hot water tank insulation kit. What they provide you is 3 insulation ribbons, which you first put on, which create an airspace for the actual insulation. This airspace increases the insulation value. Whole kit. improvements I did to the barrel is I actually double insulated this entire thing, and it showed to be quite a bit more effective in retaining heat. Then came insulating the stock pot, which was much of the same process. Created a seal for the lid. This involved putting Vaseline around the edge of the stock pot and then running a bead of silicone around the rim of the lid, and then placing the lid on top of the stock pot and allowing that to dry and set, which then creates a vapor-proof seal. Double insulated the stock pot, and also due to the fact that we were using a propane burner, I realized I needed to cut away roughly 6 inches of insulation from the bottom of the stock pot in order for it not to melt. Teflon tape around all the pieces with thread. Next came screwing in all the pieces. For the most part, I used one gasket on the inside, but in the case of the foot valve, I used two gaskets because that's where the water was running in. Those are threaded nipples that I used, which get wider as you screw them in, increasing the tightness. Insulating the steam line to transfer the steam from the stock pot to the barrel. I used a fiberglass line insulation along with this metallic insulation, which has shown to be extremely effective. You'll have to excuse me, in all my wisdom, I forgot to hold my phone in landscape for this final part, but this is the fittings all put in. I just had to insulate more around them. And here is the final product. The one thing I'll say again is that I had to add more insulation. Add another layer to each thing, except for the hose. It seemed that the pipe insulation along with that metallic insulation did just fine. And beyond that as well, in another video I will be showing you a cover that I built for the top of the boiler system as well to try and keep it in some light. to take this moment to thank everyone for tuning in. Feel free to comment any recommendations or questions, and we encourage you to like, subscribe, and follow us on all our social media platforms.